right, guys. Well, we are from Austin Middle School, and everyone here is a fifth grader, right?
Yes.
Yeah. And you guys are actually really lucky. I think you guys are luckiest of all the fifth grade class we've had before, because you guys go to a brand new building right across the street. And to a lot of fifth graders that I've talked to in the past, they're like, oh, okay, well, we're going to Austin. But brand new building, we have an awesome band room, orchestra room. These are like the biggest rooms you can have for these electives. The reason that we're here, guys, is orchestra's right here and band's gonna come in a little bit, but it's just to let you know what we have to offer for the electives, okay? There's also choir, and these are the different music ensembles you can be in. And we wanted to go ahead and show you, because some of you guys don't know that you can be in band, choir, orchestra, and we just wanted to show you what each one is a little bit about, because I know sometimes you see band or orchestra and you're like, what's the difference? And the difference is, you can already tell, orchestra deals more with the string instruments, okay, you can see them, and then band, okay, it's just more brass and there's a flutes, so it's more like using your air to make some notes, okay? And then Mr. Gano and Mr. Kraft will talk to you guys more about that in a little bit. So I'm in charge of the orchestra. My name is Mr. Arango, and we have four instruments in orchestra that you can choose from, okay? We have our violins, we have our violas, we have our cellos, and we have the bass, okay? All right, so each one of these makes a different sound, okay? I'm gonna ask the violins if they can just play really quickly, okay? And they're gonna play what's called a scale, and you're gonna hear what it sounds like. So here's violins. One, two, one, half note, go. Okay, that's our violins, okay? Now we have one that's we consider the brother of the violin. This is the viola. So can you pick up your violas really quick? Violins, can you pick up your violins? Can you see a size difference?
Yeah.
Just a little bit. For most of you, the viola is gonna be the same as the violin, okay? But you're gonna hear it's just, sounds a little bit different. Here's the violas. One, two, violas, go. Could you hear a difference?
Yes.
Some of you might be like, not really, and that's because they're that close together. The only difference between these two instruments is that this one has a different string, okay? Now, we get into our bigger section. This is the cellos, okay? And you're gonna hear a difference, okay? One, two, ready, go. Do you see how every instrument can play low notes and it gets high notes? Okay, now we have our big boy. So, by the way, this is, I'm at the bass. So this is Mr. Maciel. Mr. Maciel is the director at Izaguirre. So he's also here to help us out. So Mr. Maciel is going to show us the a scale on the bass. Hear the difference. Mr. Maciel is going to ask the question to an orchestra right now, and let's see if you guys can hear what he's going to have.
So guys, I know you've heard this before, and I'll tell you again. What is it all about?
It's all about that bass.
Have you all heard that song on the radio? Yeah? Okay. Now guys, you're gonna find out with both of these groups, orchestra or band, anything that you hear on the radio, you're gonna have the skills to be able to play those songs for your friends and family, and they're gonna look at you like you're awesome, Okay. So we're going to go ahead and play just a little tune. And this features the cellos, actually everyone. But here's what I need you all to do. Can you all close your eyes? Just close your eyes, and this is going to add to it. All right? One, two, ready. Okay. How many of you know what that's from?
Jaws.
All right. Stay away from. Just stay away from sharks. Okay. Okay. So we're gonna go ahead and play. That was just something we made up, by the way, like 10 minutes ago. But anyways, we're gonna go ahead and play a piece for you guys that actually features the orchestra, so you can hear what it sounds like when you put all these instruments together. Okay. When you guys join orchestra or band, you learn the instrument like. By itself for a little bit, and then we put it together. All right, so here's our piece called, actually, this is called Sword Dance. Okay, so guys, this is orchestra, and as you can see, everything in orchestra involves a bow and, well, an instrument made out of wood, okay? So this is orchestra, and I'm gonna go ahead and pass it on now to Mr. Cano and Mr. Kraft, and they're gonna show you the band, okay? Remember, these are classes that are offered to you at Austin, and something really quick for you to keep in mind, these instruments, if you decide to go both of them, you get to go in the morning, and you can drop off your instrument in a locker, so you don't have to carry these instruments with you to like every class. So we have a spot just for the instruments, okay? Thank you so much, guys, and then here is band.
How y'all doing?
Awesome.
Good, good. We are also from Austin Middle School. My name is Mr. Kraft. I'm the assistant director of bands, and this is Mr. Arturo Cano. He's the head director. Just like orchestra, you saw there were two teachers. Well, there's two of us here. We are stationed at Austin, and we also go to Bears High School. How many of you guys are planning on going to Austin? You better, it's right there. Well, just like you have a new campus here, we got a brand new one for you over there. Like Mr. Arongo with the orchestra said, we have this huge new facility. It's awesome. We can't wait to have you there, making some sounds. So we want to talk a little bit about band. You saw orchestra, mostly strings. This one, you mostly are going to use your lungs to make the sound. You blow into it. And there's also some instruments back there that you hit. We'll talk about those. I wanted to talk about band before we start talking about the instruments. I want to let you know that whatever you want to do, you can do it. If you want to be in band, if you want to be in sports, if you want to pursue academic, you can do whatever you want to do. Go on, guys. Raise your hand if you're in sports or UIL or anything like that. That's quite a few of them. That's a lot. We want to put them down. Thank you. And these are mostly, they're all 7th and 8th graders. Next year, when you go to 6th grade, you're going to start separate You're going to work your way up with just these instruments. We'll go baby, baby steps. We'll get you going. And then eventually, 2 years later, there you are. There's only a 3-year difference between you and them. You can do this. So we're looking forward to working with you next year. So we're going to talk about the instruments real quick, just in case. How many of you guys have ever heard of a woodwind instrument? Oh, that's cool. Y'all are smart. Well, here's the first one. It's going to be the highest pitches, the soprano voice. It's called a flute. Go on and raise it up. Y'all seen that before?
Yes.
Very cool. Very cool. Go on and put it down. There's another one, too. It uses a wood right here that you vibrate. It's called a clarinet. You might recognize it. Raise it up, guys. Squidward, right? From SpongeBob. And there's another one, of course. I'm sure you recognize it. It's called the saxophone. It's very shiny. Raise it up, guys. There it is. We also have two bigger instruments in the saxophone family. One is the tenor sax. She's in the back. Raise it up. It's a little bit bigger. And then one a lot bigger. This is one of our most advanced players, the baritone sax. Look at that thing. It's very expensive, and she's very strong, right? So that's our woodwind family. How many of you guys have ever heard of a brass instrument? Oh, yeah, y'all too. Well, they have soprano, alto, tenor sounds as well. Our soprano brass instrument is the trumpet. I'm sure you know it. Raise it up, guys. And lady. Trumpet back there, yeah. It's good. You'll know the sound from mariachi or anything like that. There's also a middle sound, and you may have never heard of it. Who's ever heard of a horn, a French horn? Oh, that's cool. Raise it up. We call it horn now, actually. The French horn was invented in Germany, played in England, and had nothing to do with France. Our other one, it starts to play some low sounds. You might see it. It's called a trombone. It has a slide. Raise it up. You see it? There's also the baritone. Raise it up. And our biggest instrument in the wind section is the tuba. Who's ever heard of a tuba? Look at those big boys. A very important thing to learn in music is that it's not just a hobby, it's a discipline. And discipline's not a consequence, it's a way to do things. You have to be disciplined and quiet and focused to be successful. So remember that too, and we'll remember you. There's one more group in the very back. They like to hit stuff. It's a lot of fun. They're the drummers. Raise them up, guys. We have all sorts of stuff. We have drums, we have cymbals, we have keyboards. You can't see the keyboards, so I'm gonna let you hear them. Here's 73. One and two and three and one, two, ready, go. Awesome, they did great, didn't they? Okay, so something you really need to know is this, and it's the same in orchestra, and there's a lot of details involved and a lot of parents involved. Not all these instruments are free. And that's something you really have to understand. Because a lot, I mean, right now, you don't have to really buy an instrument, do you? So a lot of kids, they go into sixth grade, they join this, and they don't even realize, or their parents don't, that it's not all free. This instrument I showed you, the smaller ones, the flute, the clarinet, saxophone, the trumpet, those are instruments that you have to make an investment in and purchase. In sixth grade, you can buy a smaller kind, and then maybe grow into a more advanced one if you want. For instance, I bought drums when I was 12. I still have them. Mr. Cano bought a trombone, I'm sure, you know, later on, and then he got more and more. He actually probably bought one later in college because the trombone, the French horn, and the baritone, and the tuba, the tenor sax, and the bari sax, and the percussion are provided. So if you want to play the bigger stuff, all you have to buy is maybe something to put on your mouth, a mouthpiece, and then the books and music you need. So it's not as expensive. But I got to tell you guys, every instrument has its own number. In sixth grade, we have to start 18 clarinets, 10 flutes, and so on. And I know, who's interested in possibly playing drums? Who thinks they might want to hit some drums? Okay, that's cool, that's cool. I want to let you know that if 400 kids go to sixth grade, only 10 of them get to be drummers. Out of this school, Clover, and Carmen. It's very, I don't want to say elite, but we definitely take the time to test you. I make you tap your foot. I make you copy me with sticks. So if it's something that you don't have the coordination for, we might ask you to play something else. Anyway, we'll be back later in the year to test you on these instruments. so we can put you in sixth grade if you want, okay? Let's see, is there anything else, sir? Oh, the trips? Yes, yes. There's another thing in here with band. Not only do you learn how to sit down, play, and do concerts, but you also are going to be part of activities like football games. Who's ever been to a high school football game? You see the band?
Yeah.
We do that too in middle school. It's not quite as involved, but we go to almost every game. We play at the pep rallies. We march in parades. Who's ever seen us at a parade? Some of y'all maybe. We walk up and down this road a couple times. You got to put the drum on and march around there. You got to play your instrument and march around. So you're going to learn the coordination to do all these things. Also, there's a big one. In sixth grade, we're going to take you guys to the main event, which is close. But the coolest part is in seventh and eighth, we take you to Six Flags in San Antonio. You're going to compete against all the bands in the state of Texas. We went 2 years ago. We got second place. And all of Texas. I think there was an Austin school ahead of us, but we did beat Isagete. Don't tell them. Okay, well, at this point, I'm going to go on and turn it over to Mr. Cano. He's going to talk about how each one of these instruments sound, and he's going to put together some music for you. Y'all ready for some music?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you so much for your time.
Hi, good. How are you doing, guys? Thank you so much for your patience. You know, you guys are doing very good. As I stood back here, a lot of you are sitting still. And that's a good trait to have because, as you can tell, it's you got to learn the discipline. You know, not everybody's going to get this instrument and be successful at that. But if you can sit down quietly like this the way you have been, you have a very good shot at that. Okay, so as you heard the orchestra, music is like a giant puzzle. Everybody has certain parts, and then as we play them together, we make music. Just like in your pop tunes, whatever you listen to nowadays, you know, that's what we do. So what I want to do right now is kind of sectionalize some of this music and show you what a flute sounds like, show you what a clarinet sounds like, and then we're going to run through our UIL program. You guys know what the STAR test is, right?
Yeah.
Well, we have to go to UIL, and it's kind of like STAR. They test us, and they put us in front of three judges, and they listen to us, and so that's what we're getting ready for right now. We're going to play a song entitled Adrenaline Engines. And it's going to be very exciting. You're going to hear a lot of stuff going on. It's pretty quick. So I kind of want to break it down that we know how flute sounds like, a saxophone, and the rest of these instruments here. That we can go home and be excited to your mom and dad. But mom, I heard a flute today. I heard the band. I really want to join band. And then from there, we want you to communicate to with your music teacher, with your counselors, and with us, and let us know that you want to participate in band. You know. So the first section I'd like for you to hear will be the flutes. Flutes, let's go ahead and what section was that? 57, okay? So listen to the sound, sounds very high-pitched. Okay, it's one of my favorite sounds. When you want to hear a melody, well, that's the one of the sections they give it to. So flutes, let's hear that over here at 57. And one, two, 57, and ready. Good, good. As you can tell, that part doesn't sound very interesting, but once you put it all together, it's going to sound really cool. So now we're going to pass it on to another section over here to your right, will be the clarinets. Clarinets, let's look at measure 55. Okay? Listen, you're going to hear a different sound. Their sound was kind of, you know, bright, sounds like you're blowing into some wind chimes, stuff like that. You're going to hear them. It sounds a little bit more woody. So let's see. Clarinets 55. And one, two, 55, and ready, and one. Awesome job. Give him a round of applause. Yeah. Good job. Good job. You know, as you see that, you're thinking, wow, that's so hard. But you know what? They were in your shoes a couple years ago, and they probably thought the same, and here they are playing some pretty challenging music. The next section I want you to listen to will be the saxophones. And they're right here in the center, so I'm going to get out of your way. That way you can hear them. Saxophones, we talked about what measure again? All right, here we go, saxes. One, two, and saxophones, ready. Okay, as you were told, yes, I wish we could provide instruments for you guys, but our district, you know, we're limited on funds, and we've been trying to provide as much as possible. But all these instruments that you heard are instruments that your parents would have to purchase. Okay, so understand that. I really want you to tell that to your parents. That way, y'all can sit down and talk about this. Band, you build lots of life skills. You learn how to take care of a very expensive instrument, and that goes a long way in your life. Let's move on, though. Over here to this side, French horns, or the horn section. Horns, let's look at measure 19. 19 horns, right on 19. And one, two, and one, two, three. Awesome. Round of applause, round of applause. So, as you can tell, we went from different tones, right? We went from the clarinet, saxophones had that wood type of quality. Now we have the brass quality over here in the horn section. Now, the brightest color in the brass section will be the trumpets, right back here. Trumpets, let's play the introduction. This will be beginning to the end of measure 7. Nice and strong. And 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Awesome job, Travis. Thank you. All right, so the last two groups, we have the low brass. We're going to have all the back row play. They're going to have the lowest sounding, just the way they talked about in the bass, all about that bass. Well, here's our bass section here in the brass. Here we go. This is 11, please. 1, 2, 11, and ready. Great job, Lebras. Great job. And our last section will be the percussion section. I know this is the one everybody's very excited about, okay? Now, percussion section, I know you think, what's percussion? What? It's drums. But percussion consists of lots of instruments, not just drums. We heard the mallets. We're going to have cymbals, woodblocks, bass drums, toms over there, lots of stuff. And that's the percussion section, okay? Percussion, here we go. And you know what section? 1, 2, percussion, and ready. Great job, guys. Exciting. Awesome. Well, the last thing we want to do for you guys is give your preview of our UIO program. This is our last tune that we're going to play for UIL. Again, it's entitled Adrenaline Engines. You know, you're coming into Austin Middle School. We want you to join any elective, you know, whether it's band, whether it's choir, orchestra. Understand that, and if you do fine arts, you're utilizing both sides of your brain, and that means you're going to be a much smarter student. And everybody should be happy about being a smarter student because it's all about academics. That's the one thing we preach, because if you can't pass classes, then you can't play sports, you can't be in band. So that's one thing that's number one at Austin Middle School is your academics, okay? If you have any questions, please tell your parents to call us at Austin Middle School. We'll help you out with whatever we can. We are a stone throws away. So again, please enjoy our last little run through of Adrenaline Engines. We'll be right back. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed that performance. Very exciting, right? Okay, lots of good things happening at Austin Middle School. We hope you become a part of that next year. Thank you again for your time, guys.